Estamos aquí en Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota y sin perder mucho tiempo volvamos otra vez al Hotel Eden Rock en Miami Beach para la conferencia Hispanic Size, ahora con las representantes de General Motors. So here we are, Hispanic Size 2013 with Gloria Tostado from General Motors and also Connie Berg again. Gloria, thank you for having us here. This is
welcome.
Beautiful place. Too bad this is radio, right?
Too bad it's radio, but we are in Miami, beautiful Miami.
Beautiful Miami, low humidity, a little breeze from the ocean and all that.
That's right.
So General Motors and Hispanic Size, a very important connection there, right?
We do. We've had a connection with Hispanic Size now for 3 years, three consecutive years with Manny Dries and Hispanic Size.
Yeah. Why is it important for manufacturers to come to these events? I mean, I know the obvious answer, but I want you to explain to me and our audience.
Well, for General Motors, I mean, we've been happy to be a partner for the last 3 years because for various reasons. For one, look at the folks that are attracted to this event. There's a lot of wonderful minds and interesting presenters.
Yeah.
You know, it's a world of social media. It's a world of journalism, marketing professionals, and so it's people that we want to be in touch with, that we've got a message for, and they're the messengers, if you will.
And everybody drives a car, right?
And everyone drives a car, exactly, absolutely. In fact, here at the 2013 conference, we're also the official transportation partner.
Yeah, that's great. And we're also here with Connie. Connie, you have an interesting role in General Motors because you are part of, in charge of campaigns regarding women and veterans and many different things, right?
Yes. I've been focusing on grassroots, non-traditional social media type events, and it's really been a great fit for me. It's really unleashed something in me. I've been with GM 28 years, and I've never been more fired up and enthused about my job.
Yeah, and things have changed a lot. So they need you. All companies, car manufacturers, computer manufacturers, cell phone manufacturers, everybody has to communicate in a different way now, and pretty much specific to different targets, right?
Definitely, and this really helps us reach our special niche target audiences, like the Hispanic community, because while we mass produce vehicles, we sell them one at a time.
Exactly.
And this is how we build those relationships one at a time, especially with people who, you know, speak to larger audiences on our behalf, which is way more credible than us issuing a press release.
Yeah, and another thing that is very interesting, one of the specific targets of the population that you communicate with, women. The auto industry seems to be like a male-dominated industry, but GM actually has a ton of like designers. Esther Martinez, you have I forget her name now. She works with NASCAR. She's one of the top engineers. She's from Puerto Rico. Alba, yeah, exactly. And so this is also like communicating that message. There's an opportunity to do many different things in this industry for women, right?
Indeed. You know, we are well aware of the fact that women influence 80% of the purchasing consideration buying decisions, and that should not be ignored. There's a lot of vehicles out there that are designed and engineered by and for the women's market, like the new Buick Encore, the CTS,
Malibu,
the brand new Chevy Impala, the 2014. Really proud of those vehicles, and we can speak directly to that market with our, you know, leading women executives who helped design it in the first place.
Yeah. So if you could give a message to Hispanic women who are listening or can be listening, who might be interested but might be afraid of the audience, what would you say to that?
I would say I wouldn't blame you because, you know, it hasn't always been a pleasant experience, the whole car purchasing decision, but there's so much information out there available online from, you know, bloggers and from traditional media resources. You can do your homework in advance. But, you know, feel free to drive one of these vehicles. Give our vehicles a chance. There's been a lot of people who have written us off since the 80s and have never given us another look.
Yeah, boy, I always say that the easiest thing to break in a car is its reputation.
Indeed.
And the most difficult thing to fix it is its reputation.
Indeed.
Right.
So we're in the process of winning back people one at a time. And that's why we show up to significant conferences like Hispanic Size.
And who women, women in general, Hispanic women, who like to work in the auto industry, how would you tell them, what a tip would you give them to?
I would would say pursue your passion, because, boy, it's been a big change that we have a lot of females in positions of leadership now. More than the average Fortune 500 companies, we have a higher percentage as our corporate board. We have a higher percentage of executive females. We have the highest ranking Latina in the auto industry. Grace Liebling is our vice president of global purchasing. I think that's
fabulous. She was in Brazil, right?
She was in Brazil, and she's originally an engineer.
Yeah.
So it's there's opportunity abounding.
Great. So Gloria, going back, so I guess you're going to be involved with these programs and many other different programs reaching out to the Hispanic community.
Oh, absolutely. You know, the company has been involved in the Hispanic community through affiliations and partnerships with organizations for many years now. I'm fortunate to now be in a position to assist from a national perspective. So you'll be seeing a lot more of me, and the company continues to reach out throughout the country, working with a number of organizations. It's an important community. Their opinions, what they bring to the table is important, and we want to make sure that we're there to be a part of that.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much again for seeing you here. Now I've seen you in New York, in in LA, in Detroit, so it's great to see you here in Miami, my hometown.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
Thank you, Gloria. And thank you, Gunny.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Pues aquí, esa fue la entrevista con la representante de General Motors. Información muy interesante para compartir con todos ustedes. Y para compartir con todos ustedes, escuchen la siguiente entrevista que tuvimos en el booth de Radio Shack, porque tienen mucha información sobre SiriusXM Radio, Auto 060, y una sorpresa para todos ustedes.
Here at the booth of Radio Shack and Spanish Size, and even though I should be ashamed of this because I work for SiriusXM Radio, and people ask me, how can I listen to the show besides the car? And there's the app for the phone, but there's also something else that people can find at Radio Shack, right?
Yeah, it's a SiriusXM satellite radio. It's basically the we carry is $139.99. It's a whole series. It's like the kit for the car. Basically, you remember, you just turn it on.
So, okay, I'm sorry for interrupting. So if your car is not equipped with SiriusXM radio, you can put this into the car?
Yeah, this will be the kit. It has your mount, your charger, everything, all the connections you need on it. For if you're not getting the right reception with the antenna brings, we do have additionally another better antenna for $39.99 more.
Okay.
So the starter kit is about $139.99. It's the same thing as, let's say, application. You got to go and sign up for it. It's a premium of $14.99 a month, or you could do a one pay for $180 for the whole year.
Okay. And the cool thing is that then you can take it out of the car and like take it anywhere, right?
Yeah, you can take it anywhere. If you have a docking station for it, to the beach, the house, anywhere you go, you could just connect it, click it, and you'll be hearing the radio.
So this comes with speakers, so you have to hook it up to like an iPhone or an iPad or something to have the audio out of it.
This one right here is basically for the car. This was made for a car, so this has a docking station for the car.
So when it's in the car, it connects it to the audio system in the car. Yeah, but then when you take it out, how does it work?
If you want to take it out, you'll be taking out just a piece of the Sirius FM radio, just this piece right here. I'm sure they can't see, but this right here. So you'll need a docking station for it.
Like you just with the iPod or
iPad, exactly like that.
Well, there you go, another way to listen to Auto 060 on SiriusXM Radio. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Bueno, ese fue Ezequiel de Radio Shack hablando con nosotros, y estén muy pendientes porque en la página de facebook.com Cristina Radio les tenemos una sorpresa, porque nos han regalado uno de esos equipos para que puedan escuchar el show todo, la estación de Cristina Radio Network en SiriusXM Radio, si es que su auto no está equipado con el sistema para recibir esta señal y después llevárselo a donde quieran. Así que estén muy pendientes. En la próxima semana vamos a hacerles tres preguntas relacionadas con este show que tuvimos hoy en Hispanic Size Miami 2013, y la próxima semana vamos a elegir un ganador para que se lleven este equipo que cortesía de Radio Shack, para que puedan escuchar Auto 060 y todo el resto de la programación de Cristina Radio Network aquí en SiriusXM Radio, canal 146. Así que esta ha sido la edición de hoy de Auto 060. Datos muy interesantes en la primera parte sobre la salud, el reporte de salud de los autos nuevos, luego el reporte sobre el auto sin deuda y Hispanic Side 2013. Yo soy Javier Mota, esta ha sido Auto 060. Los espero en la próxima edición.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcast.